friends. I hope you all are doing great. I hope you all had a great Thanksgiving holiday. And I'm so excited to be here today to share with you some tips on planning for the holidays. And specifically planning if you want to plan something away from home. Like you want to plan a getaway for you and your family to go away for either Thanksgiving or Christmas or anything like that. And the reason I'm doing it now is because last week for Thanksgiving, I planned to get away for my family for us to spend Thanksgiving in the Smokey Mountains. And if you are on my Instagram or my Facebook, you've seen pictures and you've heard about it. So definitely go check that out. If you have not, I'll put the links to both of them below. And it was just such a beautiful time. We had such a great time. And I want to share with you how I coordinated it, some tips I use, and the tools that I use when planning, such as my planner and how I put things together, because I do it in a way for me that it's stress-free, and I'm hoping that my tips will help you be able to plan something stress-free, so I wanted to definitely pass that along. Okay, so the first thing is, when you decide that you want to kind of plan a trip away, you want to, number one, find out how many people do you want to invite. And for us, we knew that we wanted it to be my side of the family and my husband's side of the family. It would be about 40 people. We knew we wanted to have kind of a cabin setting, rustic setting, and we knew we wanted it to be in the Smoky Mountains. And this was actually my mother-in-law's idea, and she came up with the idea, and I handled the coordination. So it really worked out great. Now, this all was thought up around September, and that is kind of late for trying to coordinate accommodations for the cabin resorts in the Smoky Mountains, because a lot of times people reserve those spaces about a year in advance. So that is one thing that I had that was a challenge for me, is to actually find a location that would accommodate about 40 family members. Initially, we thought we wanted one cabin or two cabins that were large, that would, house 20, maybe in one, 20 in the other. But number one, you couldn't find a cabin that big at this time and this late in the game. And then after thinking about it, I thought it would be nicer to have one major cabin and then smaller one-bedroom cabins where everyone could individually rent their own cabins. And so this is my first tip, is when you're planning something, whether you're going to the Bahamas or you're going to the mountains, is to make the accommodation so that each family member can call and reserve their own space. This cuts down on a lot of kind of craziness, because if you rent one place for you all, then you kind of have to get with this family member to get them to, you know, pay their portion or that. And to cut all that out, you simply find a location where everyone can call, make their own personal reservations, but you're still all together. And so I found Hidden Mountain after a lot of research, and they were great. They had one cabin that my husband and I rented, and it was for my parents, my mother-in-law, Mike and myself, my sister-in-law, which is Mike's sister, and her husband and kids, my son and my stepson. And so we all stayed in that cabin, which was larger. And I'm going to show you some footage of my prep in this video so that you can kind of see the cabin. I give you a tour of it. I kind of show you how I prep for Thanksgiving and take you on that journey also. So I hope you will enjoy that in this video also. Along with, I share with you kind of my Erin Condren planner and how I have that set up for my holiday planning. Because if you saw my first video a couple weeks ago, I did showed you my new planner that I had got for 10 bucks at Target. Threw that thing out the window, would not work. When the holidays came around, did not work for me. Erin Condren is what I needed. And so back to using my Erin Condren. Okay, friends, I made it to the cabin. I'm at the front door here. I've been here a couple hours, did some setup, waiting for my husband and stepson to get here with the rest of the items. They should be here probably in the next hour or two, not long. But I'm at the front door, and I just want to give you a tour. Now, it is nighttime, so I don't know how good the lighting is going to be, but I'm going to try this. But as you enter the cabin, it has this beautiful chandelier here. It's just really rustic and just gorgeous. And this cabin is huge. It's really a nice size, and it's perfect for our Thanksgiving. And you walk right into the great room from the front door. When you walk to the side here, they have, I think this is kind of like a closet. I think it's a locked closet. But in here we have a half bath, which is great because on Thanksgiving Day, the guests can, you know, use this bathroom here. Then as you walk in, we have a desk here, which I think I'm going to move this desk temporarily in the bedroom there so that we can put our dessert table there. And then walking, oh, and look at these ceilings. They are just gorgeous. I just love the ceilings. Gorgeous. Moving into the great room. Plenty of seating. They have beautiful furniture. Beautiful, like, just big chunky lounge furniture. The fireplace. They have a Christmas tree up, which is nice and cozy. And the TV. And then I started setting up some things. Here, this is just where I have the plates and the silverware. And I realized that I forgot the glasses. I had 48 glasses that are sitting at my house. So I think we're going to be drinking out of paper cups, which is awful for Thanksgiving. But I got to do what I got to do. But that's that. Then if you move around here, you can see that's the kitchen area. Really nice size kitchen and a long table, and the table sits 8 there. But I think I'm gonna push the table down, and then I'm going to put 2 6-foot tables on that back wall for the food table. So I think the food table will be back there, and I'll try to get a snippet to show you how it ends up. But that's there. And here, let's take you around to the kitchen. I kind of set up my little beverage station here. This is where they'll come to get like their sweet tea. We're going to have some punch, and then we also have here apple cider, and I have hot water if anyone wants tea, coffee, and okay, I'm sorry about that. I got cut off, but here's where we are going to have the beverages, and I have my 2 sternos here that are going to be one for sweet tea, one for, I think we're going to put fruit punch in that. Then I have my, you all remember my little crafts I love here. I covered them with kind of a little burlap here to give them a rustic look. And one's for hot water if anyone wants tea. I have one for apple cider, one for coffee, and then one for decaf coffee. And I just made these little signs here. And hopefully, let me see if I can get it focused. Okay, now that I got it focused, but I made these little burlap signs here. And again, hot water, apple cider, coffee, and decaf. And then I'll fill those up before everybody arrives for Thanksgiving Day. Okay, so here's the rest of the kitchen. In the kitchen, oh, and here, I forgot to show you here. I just have my little pumpkin bowls. You may remember these. And I just have the sugar, creamer, tea, and sweeteners in here. And then walking around here, I have my crock pot out. I'm going to do my hot apple cider in the crock pot. And they have a little sink here, which is going to be very helpful, along with the stove and the sink and a dishwasher. And this is just so beautiful on top here, how they have all of the pine. And I just love how it's just so nice and rustic. It's just beautiful. So if you all are looking for a cabin facility, I recommend this place. It's just really hidden. It's called Hidden Mountain. I'm going to put their information below. Definitely check them out. Check out their website. They have all their cabins on the website so that you can view inside the cabins and kind of pick and choose what you like according to their availability. So definitely check it out. But here is my parents' room. This is where they're going to stay. Let me see if I can get a little more light in here. But it has a beautiful big king-size bed. Then they have a little lounge chair and a little chest here, and try to back up there so you can see, but it's nice and cozy. And then their room leads right off to a deck where they can come out here and sit and have their morning coffee. So it's just really nice, but beautiful room. Then they have their bedroom. They have their bathroom. Let's see if we got any light in here. Oh, where's the light? Where's the light switch for the bathroom? That's interesting. Oh, maybe this is it. Oh, there it is. Ooh, I'm running into one. So, I'm running into everything. So here is their bathroom. They have a really beautiful bathroom. Love this here. Nice big bathtub. Gorgeous sinks there. So really cute. Let's turn this light off there. Okay. And then right next door to my parents is where my mother-in-law is going to stay. And this is her bedroom. Let's see if we got any lights here. There we go. another cozy room. And the great thing about her room is, as you know, both of our parents, they are on the main floor, so when they walk in the front door, they don't have to walk down any stairs or anything. And that's, you know, was a plus about this place here. And my mother-in-law, you know, she hasn't been, she's been ill lately, and so she really needed something that was handicap friendly and things like that. And so this is, and that, you know, that was huge for us, because as you can see here, she has her sink right there. She can easily get to her sink. And then her bathroom is one is wheelchair accessible, and she can just get into her shower there. So it's a handicap enabled, you know, bathroom. So it really is going to make her stay really comfortable. So I love that about this. And I'll put my the actual name of my cabin here in case you're interested in this exact cabin. But now let's go downstairs. And we have the stairs here. And let's see here. And here you go into a great room, or kind of like a game room maybe. We have the pool table here. You can go off the back there and you have a jacuzzi. And then you have another kind of little kitchen area down here. So it has a fridge, it has a sink, it has a microwave, a little table. This is where they'll probably come down and play cards and, you know, kind of just hang out, the young adults also. And then there's a bedroom on this side here with a king size bed. And this is my sister-in-law and her husband and kids. They're going to stay in here. And they have their bathroom here. And it has these bathrooms downstairs. Nice size. And they have the shower. That's beautiful. And then if you go across the hall, that's Mike, my and Mike's bath. Our bedroom. So our bedroom, we have a nice king size bed also. I love that we can go off the deck here, and there's a jacuzzi out back there and a patio and a TV, the sink and armoire. And here's our bathroom here. We have a shower also, and just toilet and shower here. The basics of what we need. And that's it. So that's the tour, and I'm going to finish prepping and getting set up, and I'll check in with you guys later. So you want to make sure that you have one contact person at the location that you're having the accommodations at, because that way, as family members are making their reservations and things like that, you can just work with that one person to kind of keep things under control. And you can also ask for a discount, because if you're having a large family kind of making reservations and things like that, 99.9% of the time you can get a discount for everyone. So definitely ask about that, a group rate. Here, this is where I kept all of my holiday prep things. And right here, you'll notice, and I need to punch that back in. I can rip it up. This here is where I kept my recipe cards, and I have them laminated. Erin Condren has the little attachments here so that you can just stick it on there and then put your recipe cards right directly into your Erin Condren planner, so that when I went up there, you know, because I cooked my food, you know, what I was cooking, I cooked it up there, but I had everything easily here. You guys know from previous years, I like to laminate and keep my recipes on little cards here, because as you're cooking, if you spill anything on them, it works out great. It doesn't mess the card up. And so I just had all of my recipes right here easily in my planner. And so it's, you know, compact. I don't have to carry anything separate or a binder or anything like that. The next section here, I just had pinned in here my menu. Kept it simple. I had everybody's name along with what they were bringing so that I could keep track of that. So simple enough. And then the next thing I had was my shopping list here. And I just had it broke down into different sections here. Just simply did this on a computer. You can do it on Pages if you have a Mac computer, or you can do it on Word. And just had my grocery list outline and basically everything that I needed to purchase for me to take out there. I also had my cooking plan of what I was going to cook in what order and that kind of thing. And so that worked out great for me there. The only other thing, and I don't want to really show this, was I had here a little card with everybody's cabin number, along with the cabin's telephone number for their cabin and their name, so that I knew everybody's kind of cabin number and that kind of thing. And so that worked out good. And that was the gist of what I needed to take with me as far as planning. That's all I really needed. Hi friends, I hope you all are doing good this morning. So we are getting our day started. It's around 9-10 o'clock. I'm still trying to wake up. Have not had breakfast, so I'm waiting to get breakfast and coffee, and then I can get rolling. I have some baking that I'm going to do this morning, and then just a little more prep work before everyone gets here. And then after that, it is just relaxed time for the rest of the trip. So that's going to be fun. Now, I am getting my shopping list together. My husband's going to run to town because some of the refrigerated items I didn't pick up before I got here, since it didn't make sense to have to travel with that stuff and get ice and all of that kind of stuff. And so he's going to go pick that up this morning so that I can get started. And other than that, that's what we have going on today. Okay, so I have the list completed and just the kind of refrigerated items that I need. So I'm going to pass this along and go from there. So as soon as he gets back, I'm going to start my baking. But until then, I'm going to start prepping some things and just kind of continue doing what I was doing. So we'll check in with you later. Okay, so here are the paper products that we're going to use for breakfast. My mom is actually going to fix a big breakfast for everyone, and so we're just going to use paper products to keep it simple downstairs. And there's a small mini kitchen downstairs that she's going to use, so I'm going to take all that down so that she has that ready. And then also just doing a little prep work here, have the salt and pepper shakers out. I have my little Cuisinart burner here that I'm going to use to put the gravy in to keep the gravy warm. Since there's a lot of people, we needed something a little bigger there. And then here, this is just the roll tops that's going to be for the cranberry sauce. So that'll just, I think I'm just going to leave that sitting on the counter here. And then I have my little, I love this, I got this from Michael's. It's a candle, but it's a turkey, porcelain turkey, so I can use this every year. And then also, I am planning to do a thankful tree at the main table for the centerpiece. So I'm going to get my stepson and my son and maybe my nephew when he gets here to go out and find me some long sticks so that I can, I bought the vase up, but I need some long sticks so that we have the tree part to hang. Everybody can kind of write something that they're thankful for on it and then hang it on the tree. And then we can pray over it before we eat our meal, Thanksgiving meal. So I thought that would be nice. And I got these for, I want to say $1.50 at Michael's. It comes 16 in a pack, so I thought that was a pretty good deal. And I have 4 packs here, so that should be plenty for everybody there. And other than that, that's what I'm doing right now. In addition, we're going to have some appetizers and things, but just wanted to put out some fruit also. And I have my Woodwick candle burning here. It smells so good, and I love that it's the Woodwick, so it has that crackling sound. And it is actually the scent of the pine scent, whatever the name of that is. So I'm going to continue with this and keep it moving. Okay, so I just did a final count to make sure I had tags for all of the desserts, because everybody's kind of bringing different desserts, and so I just kind of wanted to make sure that I had a tag for everyone's dessert. And I got these cute little, I just made the, you know, from scrapbook paper and printed out the little labels here. But what I did is I got from the restaurant supply store, they have the little holders here. And so I just got a ton of those, which they're very inexpensive. And restaurant supply stores are the perfect place when you need things like that. And I've always wanted these, so it was perfect timing for that. I also have some charger plates here because I'm going to use that to sit some of the cakes on the dessert table. So all this is going on the dessert table here. And then I have the larger cards for the cookie. I have cookie jars that to put the oatmeal cookie, peanut butter cookie, and chocolate chip cookies in. Okay, so here it is with the pine cones on there. They were easy. I just hot glued them onto the ribbon, so I think it's a cute look. I love how it turned out there. Also, you all remember my video. If not, I'll link it below where I shared my leftover station. So I put this right by our table that we have here with the plates and things like that. I had glasses. I think I mentioned this last night, but I forgot to bring them. So unfortunately, we're having paper cups on Thanksgiving, but we do have real plates and real flatware. But anyway, this is the leftover station so that everyone can pack them a little to go and take it back to their cabin. And that way they have some, you know, kind of Thanksgiving leftovers at their cabin. And I just made this chalkboard sign up here. It just says pack leftovers for your cabin. And I put a little ribbon with a pine cone on it there just to kind of give a little look there. And I need to still put the sugar and creamer and things in here. My little pumpkin bowls. Also, the drink dispensers, which I believe I showed you last night also, but I'll show you again so you can see in the daylight. But here's where all of the drinks will be. And then in the refrigerator here, we're going to have the sodas just kind of all in the refrigerator. So everything is kind of right here beside each other. Let me step back so you can kind of get a full view of how it looks. But everything is kind of right here beside each other so that when they come get their drink, they can get sweet iced tea, punch, coffee, apple cider, or go in the refrigerator and get water or sodas. And I just made the little labels here. These are the ones you might have recognized from Savannah's birthday party. I just repurposed them again and put little signs over them. So I'm sure I'll be getting good use out of those. And then these are my, you guys know I've had these a while, several years, but they're just those big carafes for coffee. And what I do is at the holidays, I always just take either scrapbook paper, or here is some burlap scrapbook paper, and it has a nice rustic look to it. And I just cover it, I just kind of tape it around to give it a different look and to make it blend into the decor for whatever holiday that I'm doing. So since it's a rustic cabin theme, it works good. And then I love that it has this picture above here, so it just kind of brings everything together for a nice look there. And then for right across from it here, I have just like the coffee stirrers and then some disposable coffee cups there. Did I show you guys? Yeah, I showed you this already about the, this is where the cranberry sauce and gravy and that's going. And then here are my cookie jars. I got to wash those and get those ready to put the cookies in because they're gonna hopefully go on the dessert table. And I'm going to get back to it, friends. Okay, so I wanted to show you guys this pan here that has been in my husband's family for over 30 years, and every holiday they cook the ham in it, and it cooks so good. It's the best pan, and it is just, it's a family tradition, and you know, it just makes the holidays. So I definitely want to share this with you guys, but it's been passed along through the sisters in the family, and so it's one that I'm sure is going to be here for years. Okay, so once you find your location, do your research, you know, look at the area. Make sure there's things surrounding the area that your family can do. They have activities, if that's what you choose. If you're in a remote location and you choose that, make sure that you provide activities on site so that everyone is kind of enjoying themselves and have things to do. And so what I did was I looked in the area. There were plenty of things that they could go off the cabin resort and do. Also, I looked at the cabins, watch videos to look and make sure that all the cabins look nice. I read reviews. And you kind of want to do all this preliminary work before you contact your family to send out the invites. So we're here in town, still in the mountains, but we're trying to go to the outlet here just to kind of check out the sales and things, but it is so crowded. Everybody and their mother in town here looks like they're going to this outlet. This I think it's Tanger Outlet. But I kind of just want to check out maybe the Coach store, if not Michael Kors. Looks like the Coach store is not too bad. So we're going to go over there and see what's going on in there. But it is definitely a busy day. Okay, so here are the bags that I ended up with. One for me, one for my mother-in-law, in that beautiful burgundy color. That's pretty. Really pretty color. Okay, friends, we just finished shopping at the outlet in town, and I found the prettiest bag. I think I showed you a clip in the store. It's this beautiful burgundy, and actually Mike's aunt, Rose, she had a beautiful burgundy bag this weekend that I saw at the cabin, and I asked her about it. I think hers is Michael Kors, but the leather, the burgundy, oh, it's just so pretty.
And then when I walked in the Coach outlet today, they had that same exact color. So I had to get that bag. So I got that one, and I got the matching wallet in another mini bag. And I'll give you a close-up of it. And I got these bangles here that were really cute out of the Coach outlet also. And then I also got the same bag and wallet and wristlet and things for my mother-in-law, so we can be twinsies. But it was just so pretty, and I really loved it. And so other than that, we're at Walmart now. I'm waiting for my husband to get back into the car. He went to pick up some things for my mother-in-law. And then we're going to head back to the cabin and just relax and enjoy our last night here. And everybody's packing up and going home in the morning. It has been so much fun. It's been so relaxing. It's so good to be around family.
Okay, so day after Thanksgiving, outfit of the daytime. We're getting ready to go take professional pictures with the fam. And so I just have on a sweater and leggings and my boots with my monogram socks here. And I'm actually going to share these next week in my holiday gift giving guide because they're really a great gift to give for the holidays. So just we're taking really just casual pictures. It's not anything professional. It's professional photographer will be there, but it's not going to be dressy or anything like that. We'll be kind of in the woods. But so I thought this would be nice and casual. So I'm going to keep going. Karaoke machine. It's by Singing Machine. It's really neat because it has a lot of different functions that I'm not used to with a regular karaoke machine, because it has where you can do duets. It has both of the microphones here. It has HD quality. You also can download your music from the internet, put it right on here. You have the LCD screen here, and it's going to be a lot of fun for Thanksgiving. We can all kind of do a little karaoke. And so I will be sharing this also in one of my favorites this year as far as a gift giving guide. So I'll give you more details and kind of take you on a tour of it, because it really is a neat gift that you can give this year. And I'll take you through and kind of show you more of the features here. But I just kind of want to share, this is kind of a nice activity that you can do around the holidays, is have a karaoke set up so that your family can kind of have fun and you guys can act silly. So, you know, think about doing that. I'll put a link in the description box below if you're interested in where you can get this one here. But again, check back next week when I do my gift guide so that you can get more details on this actual machine here, because it was sent to me by a Singing Machine. And so I'm excited for us to enjoy this Thanksgiving, and then that way I can give you more feedback next week. What I encourage you to do is, if you're planning for a large family or for a group, use email. Don't try to send out letters or anything like that, because email is going to be your quickest way to do and hit everyone and to give everyone updates and things like that. So I created an email list with all of the family members that were invited, shot it out saying, let's have a great Thanksgiving. I want to invite you to the Smoky Mountains. I outlined where we would be staying. Let me know by a certain date if you're interested in coming. And what you want to do is, key is always give deadlines, give dates, because if you just throw it out there and you don't tell them, get back with me in a certain time, then you just, sometimes they just won't get back to you. So definitely give that date. So after that date, everyone who was interested in attending, I would put them on a separate email. And then from that point, I'm only communicating with them in reference to the holiday, so that everyone who wasn't interested or not attending or can't attend don't have to see all of the email communications. I then ask them to make their reservations, pick their cabin, or, you know, and that's the great thing about this place is we had that one larger cabin reserved, but then everyone else could kind of choose their cabins, one bedroom cabins that had kitchens in them, which was great. And so everyone made their reservations. They got back with me. I worked with the resort. They gave me everybody's kind of cabin number, and I kind of kept track of that, and it all worked out seamlessly. It just really worked out great. So now that accommodations were taken care of, it was time to move into the actual Thanksgiving event. So with that, the main thing was the meal. You guys know the Thanksgiving meal. And so what I did with that was, it's too much for one person for me to just try to cook everything. You know, I knew I wasn't going to do that, nor did I want to. I think it's so, you know, much better to have a sampling of everybody's delicious food. So I got with the ladies and I asked everyone, you know, what is your preferred dish? And I recommend you doing that. You know, incorporate your family into the event. Don't, definitely don't be a dictator. Don't dictate to them. Welcome ideas, welcome suggestions. If, you know, someone else says, well, I want to bring this, then let them bring it. You know, you want it to be definitely a group effort. So, you know, whatever anyone wants to do, it can only add to the family event. So once I sent out my email saying, hey, what do you like to make or what would you like to bring? Then everyone, and of course, given that deadline, everyone gets back to me and then I create the menu from that. So I had a few people who had doubled up. So one person said that they wanted to bring banana pudding and another person said that they wanted to bring banana pudding. So what I would have them do, I said, hey, so-and-so said they would like to bring it. Get with them and you guys tell me which one, or just one of you just bring it, you know, and they don't even have to get back with me. Just one of you bring it. So we kind of coordinated there. So what I did was, if I saw anything that was doubles, I just let those, I let everyone know that, hey, you both said you would bring this, so get together and kind of, you know, work it out. Takes the stress off you, and it worked out perfectly. So my idea was Thanksgiving meal would be the only one that would be kind of coordinated by me. And I told everyone else, all your other meals for the 4 days, you kind of would be on your own. If you wanted to go out to eat, cabins all had kitchens. If you wanted to stock up your cabin and do your own thing, of course, we would have plenty of leftovers. That would work out great. What ended up happening is my husband's Aunt Joanne and my mother, they are just amazing. They surprised us, and every morning they bought up the food to cook breakfast for everybody. And so everybody came to our cabin in the morning and had breakfast. And then they also cooked, like, after Thanksgiving, the days after Thanksgiving, like a spaghetti dinner. And they, I mean, they just went over the top. They had so many great eats there, and they just stayed on top of it. And every morning we all woke up, it smells so good in the cabin. And then all the family came up and we were all in the morning by the fireplace and just eating. And it was a really special time. And the beautiful thing about it was my family and it was my husband's family. And we were just all there together. And it was just, everyone loved each other. And we just all just kind of, we sat around, we hugged each other and we just played games and we did karaoke and we went in town shopping. And it just, the weather was beautiful. To go. Now, one thing that I do next is I make sure that my husband and I, our personal items and things like that are taken care of ahead of time, because I don't like the stress of packing the night before you leave on a trip, and then running around the day you leave on a trip trying to go to Target and pick up this. I don't like that. To me, that's stressful. So if you know 2 weeks ahead or a week ahead that you're going somewhere, go ahead and pack then. You know, I packed the majority of the things that, you know, majority you can pack. So I went ahead and I packed our clothes. I got everything right so that the day of, I'm just getting in my car, driving up so that I could be relaxed. Hair appointment. Made my hair appointment way ahead of time so that the day of, I go to my hair appointment, and when I'm leaving out, that's all I did. I went and got my nails done, went and got my hair done, and then I got on the road. And speaking of hair, for anyone who had asked me about that, about my stylist, I'll leave her information below. You can definitely check her out. Also, for those who ask, she has a YouTube channel also where she does hair tutorials and makeup tutorials. I think she's just starting makeup tutorials, but I'll link her below. And also, I have a discount code if you like to go to her Amazon shop. She does all kinds of styles. She does wig styles. She can do your natural hair if you're in the Charleston area. But if you're not in the Charleston area and you want to purchase some of her styles, you definitely can do that by going to her Amazon shop. So Jaleesa's her name. She is so sweet. You will love her. So definitely check her out below and go ahead and subscribe to her YouTube channel. So for those of you who asked, I'm glad to share. So I hope you have enjoyed me sharing my tips as far as how to plan for the holidays, especially when you're kind of wanting to plan something where you go away. You know, it really worked out great for me. We are family. We just had such a great time. I hope you all are having a wonderful time getting ready for the Christmas holiday. I'll see you at the next video. And this is Nikki saying goodbye.